All right, who's the most dangerous man in the room right now? Who should I not piss off today?
I would say I am.
Okay, that's fair enough. How about Alex? Is Alex dangerous a little bit?
Oh, Alex, he can out-eat anybody.
But he's also a pretty good fighter.
Well, he breaks stuff. He goes through stuff. Or he smashes things. That's what Alex does. When you need to, somebody needs to be smashed, you call him.
He does it. He's good at that. I was talking to your son a second ago before security jumped on me. How many?
Security.
No, not the security. How many amateur fights did he have? You do amateur fights, right?
One.
That's it?
One amateur fight.
And the professional? Why? Why only one? Why not 20, 50, 100?
Why do the job for free when you get paid for it?
That's true.
Jump right in. He's gonna, I mean, the thing with the amateur is that the promoters don't know if the guy is gonna perform, if the guy is gonna have cold feet and decide to run away on the day of the fight. Well, they know our family name. We're not gonna back off, so we're gonna go to the end.
Now, your son has a clean face. Obviously, he was born into this, the whole family. Alex, looks like he's been a few wars. How do you guys keep a clean face?
Don't judge his face.
Just call me ugly, this guy. I'm gonna leave him, but.
No, but what's the secret of not getting hit?
Dude, you count on your hands how many times I got hit in my career.
That's crazy. And you fought when there was no weight classes.
No gloves. The idea is not to get hit. That's the idea. That's the plan. That's what we're passing on to him. He got the idea. But it's a fight. Anything can happen.
What do you guys think of the MMA today, the way it is right now? Compared, you were there when it started, then we fast forward 25 years or so?
25 years, yeah. Man, it's growing a lot. It's growing a lot, man. It became a science. Back then, it was just a fighter against a fighter. It was a style against a style, you see. Today became more of a science. Everybody studies, and you can get DVDs and watch your opponent and study his, and you know where he's, what school he's training, and everything evolves so much, man. It's awesome.
Recently, I saw a cookbook, The Gracie Diet. There's everything you could get today. Is that true, right? I saw it. Now, you guys know the Diaz brothers. What can you tell me about them? Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz. You're smiling.
They're very tough. They remind me a lot of my family, man. They don't back down from a fight.
Who would you want to see them fight right now?
Man, it doesn't matter. They will sell out the house. Those two,
right.
Nick and Nate, whoever you put on the other side, you see, it doesn't matter. They're going to come in to fight. It's going to be a show. They're to make friends. They're to beat their opponents up.
Have you had a chance to train with them?
No, I haven't.
Have you trained with them?
No, not yet.
But I know they're black belt.
I know them, yes.
And right now, your son's fighting Saturday, January 20th, at the Forum. It's your second pro fight. You're 1-0. Are you excited? Are you nervous? Or just another day at the office?
Another day at the office. Easy.
At what age did you have him start training?
Oh, man, in my family, we start training as soon as we start to walk.
So 1.5?
As soon as he can walk. So as soon as he can walk, we start to practice.
Floyd Mayweather's dad told me that when he was in the crib, he used to do the motions of the punches. And from 8, is that very important to start that early?
Okay, there's guys that didn't start that young and did very well. So we just guide the kids. You want your son to be a soccer player or your daughter to be a soccer player? Give them a soccer ball every Christmas.
That's true.
The playground is going to be a soccer field, so it's a basketball field if you want them to be a basketball player.
Now, obviously, Brazil is the hottest place for jiu-jitsu. It's the birth of it, correct? Where it started? Why Brazilians are so good at it?
Just been doing longer. It's on the blood, so It just would be longer.
Let me ask both you guys, who's the greatest martial artist in history, if you can name one?
My father.
There you go. I pass it to him, he passes it to another.
Why did you say your dad?
Why? I mean, that's who I grew up watching. You know, that's from my personal experience, that's who I saw live. So that's why I say him.
And now your son is continuing the legacy. Do you get nervous when he fights, or?
Not really.
Because you know he knows what he's doing.
I know what he can do, and I already, it's already in my mind. Whatever happens, it happens. You see, I told him already, just turn on the automatic pilot now. So it doesn't matter what happens, the outcome. So it doesn't matter. He already did the job. He did the training camp. He studied the opponent, didn't go out party and give up a lot of the good things for this, you see. He put his time. It wasn't like he was sitting at home, eating, drinking soda, eating popcorn, you see, and going out, getting drunk, and partying. And, no, didn't do none of that. Stay very clean, focused. So.
For those watching who are not familiar, because usually I cover boxing, what makes Gracie Jiu-Jitsu different than all the other Jiu-Jitsus?
It's the way we teach. It's the teaching method. It's a... We don't rely on strength, on speed. We don't believe there's a good student or bad student. We believe there's good teachers and bad teachers. So if you don't learn, it's our fault.
Now, speaking of people watching this video, they want to learn with you or learn with your son. How did they go to the gym? Is it open to the public or do you have to be a professional?
It's open to the public. And any of my instructors, go to my website, RoyceGracie.com. And you can see I have schools, my black belts, I voucher for all of them. So
now last thing,
schools all over the world.
We have Haim Gozali here. Haim. Oh no, I'm talking about Haim. Tell me about Danny could be in it too. You went
I thought he said Danny.
Danny, did you go to Israel with them?
Yeah.
Tell me about meeting the Prime Minister and walking with the legend, and how was it for you?
It was crazy, no?
Why?
That was like one of the top things on my list.
Yeah.
I received.
For me, it was the first. Right? I was second. You know?
Even the Israeli guys, my students were like, oh my God, you met the Prime Minister. Who would never have a chance to do such a thing? And you did it.
And I saw you wanted to...
I said, I'm part Jewish, so come on.
He threw some punches at you, right? He was throwing, he was jabbing?
Yeah.
How was his power?
He said he was training Taekwondo back in the, when he was in New York, in the U.S. So
for people who have never been to Israel, describe your experience. How was it?
They remind me a lot of like Brazilians.
It's true.
They talk loud. Everything, when they speak on their language in Hebrew, sounds like they're arguing.
Yes.
Like Brazilians. When we speak Portuguese, it sounds like we're arguing. They're very fun people. They love to have fun. The food is awesome. Very different than Brazilian food, but it's still very awesome food.
How was the experience when they were there? Did people go crazy in the streets?
And Israel is the birth of everything. Everything starts. It's the center. It's been there from the beginning.
It's like a movie star in Israel.
No, it's true. I saw the pictures in the paper of you and the Prime Minister, and then I recognized you in the hallway. I said, I saw you. And you were there too.
Yeah.
And the two fighters will compete.
Me and what? Fedor?
Oh, Fedor. He doesn't talk a lot. Great fighter.
Yes.
Now, you're a high-level black belt, correct, in Jiu-Jitsu?
I started because of him.
Why? How did you get to...
Because I saw him.
Where did you
see him? Back in 93.
See, I'm old.
I saw him in 93. And then I decided I need to do jiu-jitsu. I ordered the videotape, the basics, started to learn, and then moved to the States. And that's history, you know. And now I'm 4-degree black belt.
And still fighting.
Still fighting.
Haim told me he's an expert in fighting on his back, which is...
Because of him also.
But usually when you think of a fight, you think of standing up. How do you win fights on your back?
It's knowledge. You gotta know what you're doing. So it's not because you're on top that you win, you see. So even my father, in the last fight, I was talking just like my father. My last fight, I told my brothers, if my opponent's on top of me, he's gonna get hurt more. I better take him down, cause you'll get hurt less. Cause if I'm under the bar, I'm gonna send him to the hospital.
And you don't wanna do that.
I hope he's gonna take me to the ground in the beginning of the fight. And
so, what can you tell us about Haim Gozali, for people who are not familiar with him here in the States?
He's one of the pioneers in Israel. Now, man, we got Bellator going to Israel, we got Israeli fighters. It's one of the pioneers from Israel.
And both you guys have something in common. His son is an MMA prodigy who's doing great. Your son obviously is doing great. Is it hard being fathers and having kids fight, or do you enjoy it?
My son doesn't do MMA yet. He's 17, but he's gonna do it next year.
Okay.
But in Jiu-Jitsu, it's very
special. Do you enjoy it?
Watching it's easy. It's easier than MMA. So
it's there's an adrenaline. It's normal. But it's we did the job, we did the work, we did the homework. So now it's automatic pilot, like I said.
Okay, let me ask your son, if your dad could come back for one fight, his last fight, who would he fight now in MMA, Bellator, UFC, anything?
Well, I mean, I hope it'd be Bellator since okay. I'm signed with them, but that'd be awesome if we fought together on the same night.
Okay, who would you want him to fight?
That's up to him. Him and between whoever his promoter would be.
Any ideas, Alex? Him and Rampage?
Rampage?
I don't think Rampage can lose weight. Like Alex would say, I'm the shrimp division. That's a 180 shrimp division for him.
Haim, any idea who we can fight for one last fight? Yeah. Yeah. Anybody.
Anybody.
All right.
Where's the big money?
If they do open weight, anybody.
Anybody.
The big money. Like my father said, I just saw an interview from my father in Brazil. No, there was a Brazilian guy talking about my father. And he said one thing that marked his mind, that they stuck it on his mind when he met my father a long time ago. We're talking about 25 years ago, 30 years ago, he met my father. He said, Grandmaster Elie said, I don't care what time of the day or night it is. You knock on my door at 3 o'clock in the morning and you ask me to fight, I'm gonna get out of bed and I'm gonna beat you. I'm gonna fight you. It doesn't, so you have to be ready at all times.
It's a great philosophy. Not every fighter is like that.
There's no, I gotta get ready. No, you knock on my door at 3 o'clock in the morning, I'm gonna get out of bed and I'm gonna fight you.
You also say that, right? All right, Haim Gozali on Twitter and Instagram. Royce, no, it's your handle is not your name. It's
Hoist the real is real Royce.
Real Royce
on Instagram and Twitter.
Conor Gracie.
Like that, that's the spelling. And Big Alex, where did they follow you at?
Yes, Alex is here.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Thank you so much. Facebook.com and MySecRack reporting.